Yes, peace be to dear students. Hope all you are fine and enjoying at your homes. And you are always in my prayers. And beta, yesterday we have read fishing and horticulture. And what about fishing? Fish farming comes from an ancient Chinese technique of breeding fish in ponds. In the past, sewage was thrown into the ponds where microorganisms fed on it. These in turn were eaten by creatures slightly higher up the scale and so on, by smaller and then larger fish. And finally, the fish which died for quick growth were being bred for food, usually crab. The modern fish farms are much more sophisticated with special diet for quick growth. Unfortunately, the crowded conditions of modern fish farms means that diseases are very liable to spread, and food for the fish has to be laced with antibiotics, resulting in the same problems one finds in poultry farms. And Pakistan has a nearly 1,000 kilometer coastline on the Arabian Sea, and there are fishing villages along the coast. The Arabian Sea's waters are rich in marine life, and fishing is an occupation in the coastal villages. Why it is included in agriculture, though it produces only about 1% of human dead? Why it is included in agriculture, though it produces only about 1% of human food? So, because its advantages for health, that's why it included in agriculture. So, how Pakistan suffers because of illegal fishing in its in the new Pakistani fishermen who had been arrested by India for crossing into Indian waters, and of Indian fishermen arrested for fishing in Pakistani waters. Beyond a certain point, the waters of seas and oceans become international, and fishing vessels for other countries can also operate there. However, Pakistan's share is affected by the presence of huge trawlers from other countries. So, our next topic was horticulture. And hortus, next please. Yes, and I have told you about horticulture. That what is meant by horticulture? Horticulture is the culture of plants for foods, comforts, and beautification purposes. So, next teacher, horticulture defined as, but next. Yes. So, horticulturists grow vegetables, fruits, and flowers on a large scale. The rapid increase in the horticultural activities in the last 10 years. The flower shows by the horticultural societies in Pakistan. So, fruits and vegetable crops are also prey to plant diseases which affect the output at times. Economic supplements of leading newspapers carry interesting and up-to-date information about crops and agricultural issues. So today we will read our last topic on page number 43. On page number 43, yes, open your books, page number 43, impact of 2000 floods on Pakistan. That the people standing near a coast, it's not a coast, it's the flood. So I have already, when I was in 2010, I was in Multan. So my previous school, La Salle School, we went there for the help, the people of Alipur, the people of Bahawalpur. So in the South Punjab, I'm talking about the South Punjab, because it damaged a lot of a catastrophic flood in South Punjab. This flood came in maximum in South Punjab, and it damaged an infrastructure also, and also a lot of things there. So, impact of 2000 floods on Pakistan. The catastrophic floods, catastrophic jo tabah kun, disastrous jisko kehte hain, floods in Pakistan in summer 2010. 2010 mein tabah kun jo tha, wo salab aaya tha Pakistan mein, were the result of very heavy rains across the country. जो के हमारे मुल्क में बहुत ज्यादा यहाँ पे बारिशें हुई थी, उसका नतीजा था ये फ्लड आना. मिलियंस वर्थ ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, क्रॉप्स, लाइफ स्टॉक एंड फूड स्टॉक्स वर डिस्ट्रॉयड. उस वक्त तकरीबन लाखों की तादाद में जो लोगों की प्रॉपर्टी थी, जो लोगों के घर थे, लोगों की फसलें उस वक्त खड़ी थी, वो जो उनके माल मवेशी थे, लाइफ स्टॉक था, जो उनके पास फूड स्टॉक पड़ा था, वो तबाह हो गया था, खत्म हो चुका था. मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल वर अफेक्टेड, लाखों लोग जो थे वो इसकी वजह से अफेक्ट हुए थे. लूजिंग देयर होम्स, और जाहिर सी बात है कई लोगों के वहां पे जनूबी पंजाब में, अलीपुर में, बहावलपुर में और लैया में, मुजफ्फरगढ़ में, ये वहां पे लोगों के कई, मतलब कुछ लोगों के कच्चे घर थे, कुछ लोगों के पक्के घर थे. जब फ्लड आया उसकी स्पीड बहुत ज्यादा थी, क्योंकि रिवर जो चनाब है वो उधर से गुजरता है, और जब उसका पानी जैसे जैसे उसका बढ़ता गया तो वो वैसे वैसे गांव के गांव बहा के ले गया. द पावर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कहते हैं बुनियादी ढांचे को, एंड ग्राउंड कम्युनिकेशंस वर बैडली डैमेज्ड. जो ग्राउंड कम्युनिकेशन थी, जो मौसलात के जराए थे, यानी ये वहां पे कोई ग्राउंड कम्युनिकेशन ना रही, जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर था वहां पे, जो बुनियादी ढांचा था, वो जो जितने वहां पे घर थे, सड़कें थी, वहां पे वो पानी पानी था, और उसने बहुत ज्यादा तबाही की थी. देयर वर आउटब्रेक्स ऑफ डिजीजेस इन द रिलीफ कैंप्स. जो रिलीफ कैंप्स वहां पे लगाए गए, क्योंकि बाकी जगह पे पानी था, और उन लोगों को हमारी फौज ने बहुत बड़ा रोल इसमें अदा किया. उन्होंने लोगों को वहां से पानी से निकाला, लोगों के घरों से. इवन दो हमने खुद अपनी आंखों से देखा कि लोग अपनी छतों के ऊपर बैठे हैं, और जो उनके पास थोड़ा बहुत जो भी उनका वो समझते थे कि उनके पास कीमती सामान है, वो अपने सामान के साथ अपने घरों की छतों पे बैठ गए कि यहाँ पे पानी नहीं आ रहा, और कोई ना कोई आके हमें बचाएगा. और हमारी पाक आर्मी ने, उनके जवानों ने उन लोगों को वहां पे जाके बचाया. फिर उनको रिलीफ कैंप्स में लेके गए, और जो रिलीफ कैंप्स थे, जाहिर सी बात है वहां पे भी वो बड़े लोग थे, और को प्रॉपर उस वक्त इंतजाम एकदम से ना हो सका, और वहां पे बीमारियां वहां पे काफी थी. ओवरऑल द फ्लड्स हैड अ वेरी नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन पाकिस्तान इकोनॉमी. जाहिर सी बात है इससे हमारी पाकिस्तान की इकोनॉमी बहुत ज्यादा नेगेटिव चली गई, मनफी में चली गई, क्योंकि प्लस में वो जा नहीं सकती थी, हमारे वो सारे जो, क्योंकि ग्राउंड कम्युनिकेशन कोई नहीं थी, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वहां पे नहीं था, घर तबाह हो चुके थे, लाइफ स्टॉक खत्म हो गया, क्रॉप्स खत्म हो गई, प्रॉपर्टी खत्म हो गई। तो ये इतना डैमेज होने के बाद जो हमारे पाकिस्तान की इकोनॉमी है वो नेगेटिव में चली गई, ये 2010 का फ्लड था। सो ये इम्पैक्ट्स हैं फ्लड जो 2010 ऑन पाकिस्तान। टुडे वी हैव फिनिश्ड राइट नाउ आवर चैप्टर, दिस चैप्टर चैप्टर नंबर 4, एग्रीकल्चर एंड मेन क्रॉप्स, एंड आई विल टेक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रीकैप एंड आई विल tell you about agriculture and main crops, that what we have read the arable farming. I told you that arable farming means growing crops. So I told you about the size of the farms. We have read about arable crops like grains, wheat, millet, sorghum and oats, these all, and also the main agricultural food products like rice, maize, cacao, tea, and the cash crops also, cotton and rubber, and farming by peasants, and commercial mechanized farming. And we have read about the rice, that how it planted in the paddy fields, and their feet in the water, and the rice head in the hot sun, and why we called paddy, and stock or animal farming. we have read about the skids, that skids were used for pulling heavy loads. So selective breeding, archaeologists said that the wheel is the second most important invention in history. So after that, cattle, sheep and goats, we have already written the two notes, two long questions for sheep and goats, means 6 points for sheep and goats. So afterwards, horses, donkeys, mules, poultry, fishing, horticulture, and the last topic was impact of 2010 floods on Pakistan. So if you are seeing on your screens, here a question, first question, yes, first question on your screens, why are there no large paddy rice fields as there are for other grains? Answer, paddy fields have to be small because they have to be underwater for completely for the initial stages of germination. This means that the plots have to be completely level and it is difficult to find large areas which are flat enough. Question number 2, find out what you can about Basmati rice, which is one of Pakistan's important exports. What shape is the grain? Why is it so much sought after all over the world? Answer, Basmati rice grows in the foothills of the Himalayas in Pakistan and India. Apart from the so-called wild rice of Canada and northern USA, is the most expensive of all varieties of rice, costing from 1.30 pound to 5 pound. Like our Pakistan, if we will convert into our Pakistani rupees, 450 to 750 rupees a kilo. It has a long, white, fluffy grain which expands to almost double its length when cooked. It is highly nutritious with a high calorie content as well as vitamin B1. It also have important elements for health, such as iron, thiamine, and selenium. On top of all this, it has an excellent fragrance flavor. It is used as an accompaniment to any dish, and in South Asia as well as the West, it is also used for puddings. यानी राइस जो है, बासमती राइस जो है, वो ऑलमोस्ट पूरे वर्ल्ड में ये यूज किया जाता है. सिर्फ एक कनाडा या नॉर्दर्न यूएसए या फर्ज करें यूरोपियन कंट्रीज में देखा जाए या अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज में देखा जाए, ये हर जगह पे राइस होता है. और ये राइस जो है ये भी स्टेपल फूड है. इसको भी वो, जैसे अगर आप बांग्लादेश में देखें, आप श्रीलंका में देखें, तो वहां पे ये ऑलमोस्ट हर देश के लिए ये राइस इम्पोर्टेंट है और उनके लिए वो नेसेसरी है. ये राइस की आगे क्वालिटीज हैं. हमारे पाकिस्तान में भी बेस्ट राइस होता है और जो राइस है हमारा वो एक्सपोर्ट भी किया जाता है. और ज्यादा जो इलाके हैं जैसे जनूबी पंजाब में, हमारे साउथ पंजाब में इतना ज्यादा राइस हम नहीं लगाते. हम जो अपर पंजाब है उस साइड पे अपने राइस को ग्रो करते हैं. और उससे उन्होंने कहा कि जो बाहर है, जो साउथ एशिया और दूसरे वेस्ट में, वो उसको उसकी डिफरेंट किस्म की डिशेस बनाते हैं, वो पुडिंग्स बनाते हैं उससे. सो आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, नेक्स्ट टीचर, नेक्स्ट प्लीज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. यस, डू यू नो व्हाट एनिमल्स आर प्रेफर्ड फॉर लाइफ स्टॉक फार्मिंग इन पाकिस्तान एंड व्हाई? एनिमल्स प्रेफर्ड फॉर लाइफ स्टॉक फार्मिंग इन पाकिस्तान आर कैटल, बफलो, कैमल, हॉर्सेस, गोट, शीप एंड पोल्ट्री बर्ड्स. सॉरी, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. Why exhibitions like annual horse and cattle show in Lahore are useful? You have seen the horse and cattle show which has been held in the Fortis Stadium, and I think that you have seen already on your TVs, and also maybe some students, they went and they saw live show, horse and cattle show. So these exhibitions are useful because they help in promoting the culture and also provide income and recreation to many people. ये recreation का बहुत बड़ा source था और ये promote अपने culture को करने के लिए, आपने देखा होगा कि वो different किस्म के floats गुजरते थे और उनपे हमारे चारों सूबों का वहां पे वो लोग उसकी अकासी करते थे वो फ्लोट्स, और लोगों की सकाफत, उनका रहन सहन वो उनको शो करते थे. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. ऑल्दो फिश इज नॉट इजीली अवेलेबल एज स्टेपल क्रॉप, इट इज अ वैल्यूड प्रोडक्ट, कैन यू से व्हाई? फिश इज अ वैल्यूड प्रोडक्ट ड्यू टू इट्स न्यूट्रिटिव वैल्यू and varied use such as for fertilizer, animal feed, etc. Here it beta, when you will write here on your neat copies, please correct this question number 5, that at the very end of question number 5, can you say way, why? So next teacher, next slide please. Question number 6. What do you mean by arable land? Arable means farmable, cultivable, cultivatable, plowable, tillable, fertile, productive, fruitful, and fecund and lush. What is the difference between horticulture and एग्रीकल्चर द मोस्ट नोटेबल डिफरेंस फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर इज दैट हॉर्टिकल्चर डील्स विद स्मॉल स्केल गार्डनिंग एंड यूजली इन एनक्लोज्ड गार्डन्स ऑल्दो दिस इज नॉट अ necessity while agriculture is done on large scale with extensive crop cultivation. Agriculture is the science of growing food, crops and rearing animals for farming. Question number 8. What do you mean horticulture? That we have read yesterday and I told you today also. Horticulture is the branch of plant agriculture dealing with garden crops, generally fruits, vegetables, and ornamental plants. So these are the 8 questions you must write down in your NEET copies. This is your homework also. You must write in your NEET copies, and I have already given you 2 questions. That write a note on sheep and write a note on goat. So we have collectively, we have 10 questions. So these 10 questions you have to write down in your NEET copies, and also you have to learn these 10 questions. From Monday, we'll start our next lesson. So beta, right now, this chapter, yes, we have done this chapter. We have finished this chapter. If you have any question, right now, if you have any question about this chapter, about any topic, write it, because we have still 1 or 2 minutes. So if you want to ask any question about this chapter, about any topic, just ask me and write it in the chat box. Beta, will you write it again? Because a lot of messages came and it merged. But one by one, just ask one by one, beta. Question number 1, okay. Beta, question number 1 is, why are there no large paddy fields beta? You must write it in your geography copy, because this is from geography lesson, agriculture and main crops. Why are there no large paddy rice fields are there are for other grains? Paddy fields have to be small because they have to be underwater for the initial stages of germination. This means that the plots have to be completely level, and it is difficult to find large areas which are flat enough. यहाँ पे flat areas जो होते हैं वो कम होते हैं, क्योंकि इसके लिए जब flat होगा तो उसमें ज्यादा से ज्यादा पानी stock हो सकेगा. जितना ज्यादा पानी stock हो सकेगा वहां पे, उतनी ही ज्यादा उसकी अच्छी germination होगी. Initial stages. Yes. And one student has written that what is the change in question number 5. Question number 5. But although fish is not easily available at staple crop, it is a valued product. Can you say way? Can you say why? Yes. So any questions, beta? Is it clear to all of you? We have finished this chapter, agriculture and main crops. ओके बेटा, यस, सो थैंक यू एंड गॉड ब्लेस यू. गॉड ब्लेस यू बेटा, गॉड ब्लेस यू, गॉड ब्लेस यू. यस टीचर.